If I asked you what the hottest time of the day is, what time would you say? Would you say 12 noon straight up? Take a look at this diagram. There are many things going on here, but let's begin with this. If you look along the bottom, you can see that this is a 24-hour graph. It goes from 12 a.m. to 12 a.m. with 12 noon being right in the middle. Can you see that? Then take a look at the top, and you can see that there's a temperature curve in red. Then there's an incoming solar energy, in other words, insolation, in orange. And then down along the bottom, you can see outgoing earth energy. Let's look first at that orange curve. Notice that this is incoming solar energy. And notice this also, that the sun rises at 6 a.m. Can you see that there? And then the sun sets at 6 p.m. As I've told you before, when the sun is not above the horizon, we are not getting any solar radiation, zero. So the sun has to be above the horizon in order for us to be able to get solar radiation. As I've also told you, the sun, when it reaches its highest angle in the sky, is giving us maximum solar radiation. Remember the two things that determine insolation? Length of daylight hours and angle of the noon sun. Take a look at where that blue arrow is at, and you can see that blue arrow is pointing at 12 noon straight up. This is also showing you that that is the time when we have maximum solar radiation. If you look over to the left of that orange line, you can see that right at 6 a.m., what's going to begin to happen is the sun comes above the horizon. It's at a very low angle, but we begin to receive insolation. And then after 12 noon, you can see that we are slowly decreasing the amount of insolation we're receiving from the sun until at 6 p.m., it's gone. There's that graph highlighted in blue. Can you see that? That represents solar radiation. Now look at this red line. I have this green arrow pointing at it. That red line indicates air temperature through the day. We're assuming that this is a day when there's no storms, there's no Santa Ana conditions, there's nothing weird happening in the atmosphere. It's a regular average day. Notice when you look at that red line, here I've highlighted it in green, notice that where it says max, that's going to be the highest temperature of the day. Notice how that does not correspond with maximum solar radiation, which happens at 12 noon. You can see this right here with that blue arrow. That is indicating maximum solar radiation. The sun is at its highest angle in the sky. This green arrow is indicating when we have our highest temperature. Notice that that's almost 4 hours after 12 noon. That's very common, that the highest temperature of the day is actually going to be 2 to 4 hours after the sun reaches its highest angle in the sky. Now, if you look at that yellow arrow, you can see it's pointing at the blue line. The blue line represents outgoing Earth energy. In other words, long wave radiation. Here I've highlighted it. Notice that outgoing Earth energy reaches its peak about the time that we have maximum temperature. When you look out at the sun at noon, can you really tell the difference between noon and 12:15? I can tell you that I really can't. Can you even tell when it's 1 o'clock? Sometimes it's difficult for me to do that too. You see, at 12 noon, when the sun is reaching its highest angle in the sky, there's not really a whole heck of a lot of difference between 12 noon and 12:15 in terms of the angle. The sun is still close to its highest point in the sky. What that means is this: we have a surplus of solar energy in the atmosphere. And that continues to sometime between 2 and 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Because we have that surplus of solar energy, temperatures are able to continue to go up. In other words, what's happening is there's more shortwave radiation coming in and heating the surface than there is longwave radiation going out. Because of that, we're continually building up this surplus of energy in the atmosphere until the sun reaches a point 3, 4 o'clock in the afternoon on a day like this, when we have 12 hours of daylight and 12 hours of darkness that's being graphed here. where the sun is actually beginning to get so low on the horizon that there's more long-wave radiation going out than there is short-wave radiation coming in. At that point, we begin to run a deficit. More long waves are leaving than short waves are coming in to replace it. And what happens, of course, is we begin to drop the temperatures. Once the sun goes down, of course, there's no solar radiation and temperatures continue to drop throughout the night. And you can see just before 6 a.m. when the sun rises, this is when we reach our lowest temperature for the day under normal circumstances. And this is because we're losing energy. We're running a deficit all night long. And then the moment the sun comes above the horizon, at that moment, we can begin to replace the energy we've been losing all night and temperatures can begin to go back up. This is called the daily march of temperature or the diurnal temperature lag. Diurnal is just a swanky word for daily. It describes the changes in temperature over a 24-hour period, with the warmest temperature being 2 to 4 hours after the sun reaches its highest point in the sky, and the coolest temperature is just before sunrise. That warmest temperature is because of a surplus of energy in the atmosphere, in the Earth's system. In other words, again, more shortwave energy is coming in than longwave going out. The result of that is temperatures are able to go up. Once you get past that point, whether it's 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, we begin to run a deficit. In other words, there's more longwave energy going out than there is shortwave energy coming in, and temperatures begin to go down.